One. Two.
Since we're in the church, you know, you get it? Church mice? No? Nobody? Okay. All right. So I'm going to tell you a story that somebody told me, okay? But I'm going to need your help. When I say, little pig, let me in, you say, not by the hair on my chinny, chin, chin. Can you guys do that for me? Let's practice real quick. Hey, little pig, let me in. Come on, I thought you guys were smarter than that. Let's go. Little pig, let me in. Oh, that's beautiful. I'm also going to need some volunteers. I need somebody to behave. Who's going to behave? You behave. I need somebody to be sticks. Who's going to be sticks? It's my man Sticks over here. And then I need somebody to be Brick. Who's going to be Brick?
I love you, yes.
My girl Brick over there. All right. Hey, well, did I pick Hay? Hay, Sticks, Bricks. All right, but I don't need you right now. Sit up, sit up, sit up. Okay. So my name is Wiley Wolf. You guys may know me, you may not know me, but I'm going to tell you a little bit about me today. In fact, yeah, I dyed my, used to be brown and black, but I dyed it red so folks don't know my identity. Okay, but I'm a wolf at heart. So my name is Wiley. Now listen to me, listen to me. My buddy Peter came over to the house the other day. I was sitting, minding my own business, just sucking my lollipop like this. And I heard a bang on the door. I said, who is at my door? I opened, and there he is, Peter Pig. I said, Peter, what are you doing in my house? He said, Wiley, I have a story for you. I said, Peter, we're not even that cool. We're not friends. What are you doing in my house? He said, Wiley, step out of the way. Can I come and talk to you? You're not going to let me in? So I said, okay, come on, have a seat. So Peter Pig is sitting there in my house saying that he had a story for me. I said, Peter, what are you doing here? Do I owe you something or something? He said, no. He said, Wiley, you know you've had some run-ins with me and my brothers, haven't you? I said, yeah. You all know the story. I remember when you and your brothers just left your mama's house. You went out. I think your little brother went to go make a house of hay. Where's hay? Come over here, hay. I remember that story like it was yesterday. So you made a house full of hay, and I saw that. And I said, I'm feeling hungry today. So I came up to the house and I said, hey, little pig, let me in. He wouldn't let me in, Peter. So I said, I'll huff and I'll puff. I'm going to blow this house down. And hay fell over. And I saw that little piggy ran over to his brother's house. So he went, you can go and sit back. Hey, thank you so much. And so he went over to Sticks' house. Come on, Sticks. Come on, Sticks. Come on, stand over here. I need another Sticks. Come on, Sticks. So I went over to Sticks' house. And Peter said, yes, you did. You went over to Sticks' house. And I said, hey, yo, little pig, let me in. And I said, okay, I'm a huff. I'm a puff, I'm a blow it in. Then I blew that Sticks down. And the little pig ran over. He said, yeah, Wiley, where did he run to? I said, well, he ran over to your house. He went over to Bricks. No, we have Bricks over here. This is Bricks over here. Come on, stand up, Bricks. And so I went over. I said, but I'm gonna try anyway. I was a little hungry, okay? I want a little bit of bacon, if you know what I'm talking about. All right? And so I said, hey, yo, little pig, let me in. I said, I'm going to try. And I blew.
Two leaves in there.
And I blew. It didn't work. The house was solid. So I said, I'm gonna try something else. I'm gonna go on top of the roof and come through the chimney. And Peter said, yes, you did, but what was waiting for you down there? Well, you guys were a little smarter. As soon as that heat touched my tail, I flew out. Thank you, Bruce. And I said, Peter, why are you telling me this? We already know this story. He said, you know what you did after that? I said, yeah, I used to mess around with you guys all the time. I remember you guys were swimming in the swimming hole, and I came in and took your clothes, and I threw them in the bush. You had no clothes. It was so mean. I remember one time you guys were playing basketball, and I crawled up under the bench, and I tied your shoelaces together. See, the way you got up? You son. And he said, yeah, Wiley, we hated you for a long time, because you're always bullying us. But let me tell you something, Wiley. I got a message from God the other day. I said, you got a message from God? He said, yeah. He said, hey, yo, Peter, you need to go tell Wiley that if he doesn't stop messing with you, I'm gonna blow him away. I said, Peter, God told you that? He said, yeah. But I did not want to tell you. He told me to tell you that he's gonna blow you away. But I didn't want to warn you. So guess what I did? Got in my car, drove to the airport, found a little pilot, and flew away. I said, Peter, what are you telling me? You telling me God told you to do something and you ran away? That's not very smart. And I know, but I was scared. I wanted you to be blown away so bad. But while we were on that plane, Wiley, can I tell you what happened? Not one, not two, but three engines blew out. And their plane was going like this. And the pilot was trying to run it, and it was going down, and all the luggage was flying everywhere. And I knew in my head, Wiley, I knew it was my fault, because I was running away. So I told the pilot, I said, yo, pilot, captain, it's my fault. Throw me out this plane. And the pilot said, no, we can't do that. We're gonna try and save it. We're gonna try and save it. I said, commander, pilot, captain, whatever you call yourself, throw me out this plane. And so they grabbed my feet, they grabbed my hands, and one, two, whee! They threw me out of the plane. I said, pause. Are you telling me that you're standing here today, Peter, after being thrown out of a plane? Why, it doesn't even stop there. As I'm falling out of this plane, right before I hit the floor, I see, off in the distance, the biggest bird I had ever seen. And it just swallowed me up. I said, Peter, you're telling me that you got swallowed by a bird? Yes, I did. And as I was squeezing down his throat and landing in his stomach, oh, it was nasty. There were worms in there, fish in there, all types of guts and everything. Oh, it was gross. And I knew one thing, Wiley. I knew that I did not want to come out as bird poop. I did not want to do that. So I'm praying. I said, God, I'm sorry. I should not have run away when you told me what to do. Please get me out of this bird. Get me out of this bird. And I waited, and I waited, and then I felt something bubbling. And I saw the bubbles in the water gurgling. And then all of a sudden, the bird threw me up. And I was in a nest. I said, let me get up out of this nest before the little chickies come and try to eat me. And I came down at that nest, and Wiley, do you know where I ended up? I said, Peter, I am waiting to know where you ended up. Right at your door. And that's why I'm here right now, to tell you that if you don't stop messing around, God is gonna blow you away. And I said, whoa, man. God told you to tell me that? That I need to stop messing around with you and your people? Okay, I'm done. I won't do it anymore. I'm a changed man, Peter. I promise you. If God told you to come and tell me to stop doing what I'm doing, I'm going to stop. Thank you so much for telling me. And Peter walked out. And now I'm a changed man. I share things now. In fact, if you all want lollipops, you come after church and see me. I'm getting each and every one of you a lollipop because I'm a changed wolf. And it's a lesson for you. If God tells you to do something, you need to do it. Because it might not just save your own life, it might save somebody else's life. So listen to God's instructions and don't run away. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you so much for this day and for bringing us to church. Thank you that you want to save us and you want to heal us and you want us to change. Show us how we can hear, listen, and obey your word and tell people about you, so that our lives can be saved and their lives saved as well. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. 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 Shout out to Joshua, Joy, and Jael, who inspired that story. You guys recognize what that story was from? Thank you, Joy, Joshua, and Jael, for inspiring that.
I didn't. They did.